next verse. Here we come up with gross anatomy lecture of tributaries of the internal jugular vein, subclavian vein, and brachiocephalic vein. So our title is tributaries of internal jugular vein. In short, it is called IJV. Also, subclavian vein and brachiocephalic vein. Now, why this topic is chosen is so many names of these tributaries are asked as MCQs or one mark question answer. So, it is mandatory for the students to remember the names of these three tributaries. Many a times it is asked in MCQs or one mark question answer. So, here we go with the, we start with diagrammatic base only. So, therefore, if we draw the diagram here, we start with the internal jugular vein. So this is our internal jugular vein, one side, and on other side. So therefore, this is the bulb, and that is sigmoid sinus. So therefore, after drawing this internal jugular vein, we put in some color inside and we start with subclavian vein. Now the subclavian vein coming from the lateral side. So the subclavian vein, we should join it over here. This will be the subclavian vein. So therefore, subclavian vein. And here in this subclavian vein, after joining the internal jugular and subclavian, they will form brachiocephalic vein, the right and left brachiocephalic vein. So therefore, we are going to draw here the brachiocephalic vein on the right side as well as on the left side. So both the brachiocephalic vein, right and left, they are formed by the union of internal jugular as well as subclavian vein. Simple. So therefore, we are going to name this structure over here as internal jugular vein. We are going to name this structure over here as subclavian vein. And we are going to name this structure over here as brachiocephalic vein. Now please note down, this is left side, this is right side, and this is left side. So here we are going to name this as right side, and we are going to name this as left side. Very simple, right and left. Now the tributaries. We start with internal jugular vein. In the internal jugular vein, how to remember the tributaries? You start with the first tributary. So on this side, I'm going to keep on writing the tributaries. Sigmoid sinus. This is the first tributary, sigmoid sinus. This bulge signifies sigmoid sinus because that will continue through the jugular foramen as internal jugular vein. We all know that. So first tributary. Second tributary will be, it will receive from one side, you show this arrow, and that is inferior petrosal sinus. So that is tributary number 2, inferior petrosal sinus. Tributary number 2 of internal jugular vein. So tributary number 1, internal jugular vein, sigmoid sinus, tributary number 2, inferior petrosal sinus. Then we start with, from here, we start, for example, superior thyroid, lingual, common facial, and straight away we write down the superior thyroid vein, that is 3, tributary number 3, lingual, tributary number 4, common facial vein, tributary number 5. superior lingual and common facial. And then we show here, this will be pharyngeal. So here pharyngeal vein, that is tributary number 6. Same way over here, superior thyroid, lingual, facial, that is common facial and pharyngeal. So all together, sigmoid sinus, inferior petrosal sinus, superior thyroid, lingual, common facial and pharyngeal. Total 6 tributaries. Now, one from opposite side. This opposite side tributary will be known as occipital vein. So here we write occipital vein. And this occipital vein will be tributary number 7, occipital. Just above occipital, we show oblique jugular vein. So here we will name this as oblique jugular vein. That is coming from external jugular vein. So it is a connection between external jugular and internal jugular. So tributary number 8. And tributary number 9, the last one. Here we show. This will be middle thyroid vein. So middle thyroid vein. And this will be tributary number 9. Here we finish the 9 tributaries of internal jugular vein. Once again, we start from 1 to 9. They are sigmoid sinus, inferior petrosal sinus, then superior thyroid, lingual, common facial, then pharyngeal. Then we have this as occipital, then we are having this as oblique jugular, and the last one, middle thyroid vein. Please remember these 9 tributaries of internal jugular vein. Then we shift to subclavian vein. In the subclavian vein, I will take the help of this side, so it will not be congested. Here, on one side we are going to show subclavian vein. If this is the subclavian vein, tributaries of subclavian vein. Very simple to understand, remember, number 1, this will be external jugular vein. So therefore, we will draw it slightly thicker. So we draw it like this, external jugular vein. I am going to write here, number 1, external jugular vein. This is the first tributary of the subclavian vein, both sides, right and left. Second will be anterior jugular vein. So here I will write down number 2, anterior jugular vein. Then number 3. Now number 3 I am going to show over here, and this I am going to write down as dorsal scapular vein. So this will be number 3, dorsal scapular vein. Three tributaries, the three main tributaries of the subclavian vein on either side, right and left, there will be the external jugular vein, anterior jugular vein, dorsal scapular vein. Now at the junction of subclavian and internal jugular vein on both the sides, at the junction of internal jugular and subclavian vein, here also internal jugular and subclavian vein, at the junction there will be tributaries such as, or opening up of, on the right side we are going to mark, this is the right side, so on the right side, right lymphatic duct, the right lymphatic duct. And you can name this as tributary number 4. Although it is not the tributary of right subclavian vein, it is opening in the junction of the right subclavian and right internal jugular vein. Then also, according to some textbooks, they have mentioned it as the tributary number 4 of the subclavian vein, right lymphatic duct. Similarly over here, if we come on this side, This, we will name this as number 4 on the left side, and it will be the, it is called on the left side the opening of thoracic duct. That is the left side lymphatic duct, which is called thoracic duct. On the right side, it is called right lymphatic duct. So this is also, thoracic duct is taken as tributary number 4 of left subclavian vein. Although it opens into the junction between subclavian and internal jugular, that is thoracic duct. Here we finish the tributaries of subclavian vein. Now brachiocephalic vein. Tributaries of brachiocephalic vein will be, if we extend this brachiocephalic vein further, we are extending just further so that we get more space. Now the tributaries which we are going to draw, they will be number 1, vertebral veins. So here we show on this side, these two will be the vertebral veins on right and left both. So therefore, on this side we are going to name number 1, vertebral veins, tributary number 1 of brachiocephalic vein. Remember, tributaries of brachiocephalic vein, right and left both, vertebral veins. Second will be inferior thyroid vein. So we draw here inferior thyroid vein and we write tributary number 2, inferior thyroid vein. Very important. Many a time students are confused between superior thyroid vein, middle thyroid vein, inferior thyroid vein, and they ask this MCQ also, that inferior thyroid vein is a tributary of ABCD options, subclavian or whatever they mentioned, brachiocephalic, etc. But always note down, superior and middle thyroid veins are tributaries of internal jugular vein, superior and middle thyroid, and inferior thyroid vein is a tributary of brachiocephalic vein. Always note down. That is very confusing, but you, by this diagram, it should be very clear. So, tributary number 1 of brachiocephalic vein will be vertebral. Tributary number 2, inferior thyroid vein. Now, tributary number 3. You draw from inferior side this tributary and it will signify the internal thoracic vein. So, therefore, this is tributary number 3, that will be internal thoracic vein. This is tributary number 3, internal thoracic vein. So therefore, vertebral, inferior thyroid, internal thoracic. Now, tributary number 4, there will be the first posterior intercostal vein on both the sides. So here we draw the first posterior intercostal vein and we write it as, on this side I will write tributary number 4, and that is the first posterior intercostal vein. Please note down tributary number 4, first posterior intercostal vein, both right and left brachiocephaly. So four tributaries of both the sides are over: vertebral, inferior thyroid, internal thoracic, and first posterior intercostal vein. Now one tributary which is not present on the right brachiocephalic vein, it is not a tributary of right brachiocephalic vein, but it is only the tributary of left brachiocephalic vein. Note down that tributary, and that will be, here I am going to draw on this side, this tributary. So this tributary here will be known as the left superior intercostal vein, which is not present on the right side. It is not present on the right side. It is present only on left side. Left superior intercostal vein. So here we are going to note down tributary number 5. And I am having that space over here. So I am going to note down here tributary number 5 on the left side. the left superior intercostal vein. The left superior intercostal vein. Please note down. So, it is not present on the right side. So, tributaries of right tracheocephalic vein, vertebral, inferior thyroid, internal thoracic, and first posterior intercostal vein. Tributaries on the left tracheocephalic vein, vertebral, inferior thyroid, then internal thoracic, then first posterior intercostal vein, and additional left superior intercostal vein. The left superior intercostal vein is formed by the fusion of the left side, second, third, and fourth intercostal veins. So therefore, now here on the left side, one is extra, that is left superior intercostal vein, and one more vein will be extra. Sometimes, rarely, occasionally, these veins are thymic veins. So sometimes, here you can mention tributary number 6 on the left side. It is given in some textbooks. Thymic veins will also be present. And these thymic veins are draining the blood from thymus. That is why they are very important. So thymic veins. And these thymic veins will drain the blood from thymus and will open directly into the left tracheocephalic vein. Note down. So therefore, total 6 tributaries on the left tracheocephalic vein, in the left tracheocephalic vein, and total 4 tributaries in the right tracheocephalic vein. It should be very clear. If you remember this diagram, it will help you in the fetching 1-1 mark question answers or lot of MCQs, 1 mark MCQs. That is why this diagram is very important. Try and remember, memorize this diagram. So here we finish the tributaries, all the 3 veins, the tributaries of intraclavian, subclavian, and brachiocephalic veins. Thank you very much.